One of the potential DC Comics films we are most excited about is Gotham City Sirens, which would feature Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn, easily the best part of Suicide Squad, and unite her with her fellow Gotham bad girls Poison Ivy and Catwoman. Not much is known about this movie quite yet, except that Suicide Squad director David Ayer is reuniting with Robbie as her director for this film. Recently, some Reddit users noticed that Ayer started following Baby Driver actress Isa Gonzalez on Twitter, and that Gonzalez had a conspicuously short Selena Kyle-esque haircut, leading many to believe that he is eyeing her for the role of Catwoman. While this is possible, it has led us to wonder who our ideal Gotham City Sirens version of Catwoman would be. Our criteria for an on-screen Catwoman would be as follows. First off, no super young starlets. If she is a romantic contemporary to 40-something Batfleck, then please, make her age-appropriate. I think we are all sick of seeing 21-year-old women paired with men twice their age. Not that this doesn't happen in real life or that it's wrong, it's just done to death in movies. We're over it. This is Catwoman, not Catgirl. Second, no one famous for being perky or bubbly. Catwoman has an edge, and we are looking for actresses that carry with them an edginess in whatever role they play. This is a character that rides the line between hero and villain, noble and selfish. So sorry, Anna Kendrick, we think you're a great for Squirrel Girl, but not Catwoman. Here are our top 7 choices we think should play DC Comics 1 femme fatale. 7. Rosario Dawson. Image Marvel Netflix. Rosario Dawson might be a tad complicated, if only because her contract with the Marvel Netflix shows, where she plays the closest thing Marvel's heroes have to a healthcare plan, Nurse Claire Temple, might not allow her to play a live-action DC Comics character. She did voice Batgirl in the Lego Batman movie, for what it's worth. But if she doesn't have such a clause, she would be an ideal choice to play Selina Kyle. Her role as Claire Temple shows a character who is deeply dedicated to the people in her local neighborhood, which is a very Catwoman trait. 6. Zoe Saldana. Image Paramount. Yeah, I know. She's already in Avatar, Star Trek, and the Marvel Cinematic Universe's Gamora, so just like Rosario Dawson, she might not even be allowed to play a DC Comics character. But in an ideal world, Zoe Saldana has the exact right energy for the non-incense Selina Kyle, and I think most of us would pay real money to see her in a rooftop fight with Batman. 5. Eva Green. Image Showtime. If you had Penny Dreadful for any of its 3 seasons on Showtime, you know that Eva Green was sublime as Vanessa Ives, a woman who struggled with both the light and the dark sides within her. While there are vast differences between Vanessa and Selina, a balance of light and dark is essential for Catwoman, and we know Green could do this role in her sleep. 4. Tandy Newton. Image HBO. Although Tandy Newton has been working in Hollywood for years, her turn recently on Westworld has left all of our jaws dropped by how amazing she is as a robot who begins to acknowledge her own sentience. I can totally see her inhabiting the jewel thief extraordinaire and giving the younger Harley and Ivy a proper big sister figure. 3. Sophia Boutella. Image Focus. Features. After her recent turns in Kingsman: The Secret Service and Star Trek Beyond, we know that Sophia Boutella can get the kick-ass action parts of Catwoman down. We won't hold the recent Mummy reboot against her. But Boutella also has all the charm and vulnerability that Selina would need, as shown by her recent role in Atomic Blonde, too. Rebecca Ferguson. Image Paramount. After her star-making turn in Mission Impossible Rogue Nation, we've all been waiting to see Rebecca Ferguson tackle another major action role, and I could easily see her cracking the whip and kicking Batman's ass, all while charming the utility belt off of him at the same time. Her character in Mission Impossible always had shifting allegiances but was ultimately good, all very Catwoman traits. 1. Ruth Negga. Image AMC. My one choice to play Selina Kyle would be Preacher star and Oscar nominee Ruth Negga. This lady has some serious acting chops, and would just absolutely own this role. The role of Tulip O'Hare on Preacher might be a tad too similar to Catwoman, both criminals with hearts of gold, but there are enough differences that playing Selina would be an interesting challenge for Negga. Also, I can already see her truly epic eye rolls at the loony antics of Harley and Ivy. No one does eye rolls like Ruth Negga. While any of these talented women would be great, we think Ruth Negga would be the best. Who do you want to see cast as DC Comics' greatest anti-hero? Give us your thoughts down below in the comments. What else is happening in the DC Universe? Hear Kevin Conroy read Batman's epic The Dark Knight speech. Images: DC Comics, AMC, Paramount Pictures, HBO, Showtime, Marvel Television, Netflix. Focus features: Catwoman, David Ayer, DC Comics. Fan casting: Gotham City Sirens, Rebecca Ferguson, Rosario Dawson, Ruth Negger, Selena Kyle, Sophia Boutella, Tandy Newton, Warner Brothers, Zoe Saldana.